Europe in all its glory again, a new enlightenment, with Germany back in her rightful place at the heart of it. And who led the way for everyone else?
You and Niels.
Well, we did.
We did.
And that's what you were trying to get back to in 1941.
To something we did in those 3 years. Mm. Something we said, something we thought. I keep almost seeing it out of the corner of my eye as we talk. Something about the way we worked. Something about the way we did all those things.
Together.
Together. Yes, together.
No.
No? What do you mean, no?
Not together. You didn't do any of those things together.
Oh, yes, we did. Of course we did.
No, you didn't. Every single one of them you did when you were apart. You first worked out quantum mechanics on Heligoland.
Well, it was summer by then. I had my hay fever.
But on Heligoland, on your own, on a rocky, bare island in the middle of the North Sea, you said there was nothing to distract you.
My head began to clear. And I had this very sharp picture of what atomic physics ought to be like. I suddenly realized we had to limit it to the measurements we could actually make, to what we could actually observe. You can't see the electrons inside the atom.
Any more than Niels can see the thoughts in your head, or you the thoughts in Niels.
All you can see are the effects the electrons produce on the light that they reflect.
Yes, but the difficulties you were trying to resolve were the ones we'd explored together over dinner in the flat on the beach at Tisvila.
Of course, but I remember the evening when the mathematics first began to chime with the principle.
On Heligoland.
On Heligoland.
On your own.
It was terribly laborious. I didn't understand matrix calculus then. I get so excited, I keep making mistakes. But by 3 in the morning, I've got it. I seem to be looking through the surface of atomic phenomena into a strangely beautiful interior world, a world of pure mathematical structures. Oh, I'm too excited to sleep. I go down to the southern end of the island. There's a rock jutting out into the sea I've been longing to climb. I get up it in the half light before the dawn and lie on top, gazing out to sea.
On your own.
On my own. And yes, I was happy.
Happier than you were back here with us all in Copenhagen the following winter.
What, with all the Schrödinger nonsense?
Nonsense? Oh, come, come. The Schrödinger wave formulation?
Oh, yes, suddenly everyone's turned their backs on your wonderful new matrix mechanics. Yes.
No one can understand it.
And they can understand Schrödinger's wave mechanics.
Because they've learned it in school. We're going backwards to classical physics. And when I'm a little cautious about
Not to criticize.
You described it as repulsive.
I said the physical implications were repulsive. Schrödinger said my mathematics were repulsive.
I seem to recall you used the word, well, I won't repeat it in mixed company.
In private, but by that time, people had gone crazy.
They thought you were simply jealous.
Someone even suggested some bizarre kind of intellectual snobbery. You got extremely excited.
On your behalf.
You invited Schrödinger here.
For a calm debate about our differences.
And you fell on him like a madman. You meet him at the station, of course, and you pitch into him before he's even got his bags off the train. Then you go on at him from first thing in the morning to last thing at night.
I go on. He goes on.
Because you won't make the least concession.
Nor will he.
You made him ill. He had to retire to bed to get away from you.
He had a slight feverish cold.
Margrethe had to nurse him.
I dosed him with tea and cakes to keep his strength up.
Yes, while you pursued him even into the sick room, sat on his bed and hammered away at him.
Perfectly politely.
You were the Pope, the Holy Office, and the Inquisition all rolled into one. And then, after Schrödinger had fled back to Zurich, and this I will never forget, Bohr, this I will never let you forget, you started to take his side. You turned on me.
Because you'd gotten mad by this time. You'd become fanatical. You were refusing to allow wave theory any place in quantum mechanics at all.
You'd completely turned your coat.
I said that wave mechanics and matrix mechanics were simply alternative tools.
Something you're always accusing me of. If it works, it works. Never mind what it means.
Of course I mind what it means.
What it means in language.
In plain language, yes.
What something means is what it means in mathematics.
You think that so long as the mathematics works out, the sense doesn't matter.
Mathematics is sense. That's what sense is.
But in the end, remember, we have to be able to explain it all to Margrethe.
Explain it to me? You couldn't even explain it to each other. You went on arguing into the small hours every night. You both got so angry.
We also both got completely exhausted.
It was the cloud chamber that finished you.
Yes, because if you detach an electron from an atom and send it through a cloud chamber, you can see the track it leaves.
And it's a scandal. There shouldn't be a track.
According to your quantum mechanics.
There isn't a track. No orbits, no tracks or trajectories. Only external effects.
Only there the track is. I've seen it myself, as clear as the wake left by a passing ship.
It was a fascinating paradox.